Now that we have seen how to calculate E naught of a given cell using the cathode half cell and the anode half cell, we can calculate what is the E cell. Okay. E naught cell is actually the standard potential. For example, you may have Daniell cell, but anytime anybody asks you what is the potential of a Daniell cell, anybody can say 1.1 volt. But the size matters. What if I take 2 molar copper, so 2 plus, or 0.1 molar zinc 2 plus? So the potential of that cell is different. The standard reduction potential has not changed for the cell. Standard reduction potential is standard condition 1 molar, that is still 1.1 volt. But what is the actual potential of the given cell? So this is where you need to use an equation called Nernst equation. So Nernst equation is something that relates your E cell to your E naught cell. So E cell and E naught cell are equal when you are using, looking into 1 molar concentration of your products and reactants. But what if they are not 1 molar? So how are they related? So you can have E naught cell minus RT by NF ln Q. Q is nothing but activities of products over activities of reactant raised to the corresponding coefficients. We saw this in equilibrium chapter. Activities can be replaced for concentrations or pressure. Okay. So, concentrations of product over concentration of reactant raised to the corresponding coefficient from the balanced chemical equation. Now, I am using a specifically a symbol Q, not K, because we don't know whether we are at equilibrium. Now, what we can do? We can simplify this. So, the value of F is 96,485 coulomb per mole. The N is number of electrons in a given process. Sorry, T is temperature in Kelvin, R is 8.314 joule per mole Kelvin. E naught is related to thermodynamics, so it is a thermodynamic parameter that you want to use, 8.314. We can simplify this. E naught cell minus, if you put the corresponding values for R, temperature 298 Kelvin and 96,485, and also you convert LN to LOG by multiplying by 203, you will get a simplified value of 0.0591 by N. I have not put the value of N because it changes from reaction to reaction, log of Q. And this is the simplified version of Nernst equation that you have to remember. Now, a couple of things you want to know. Balanced chemical equation is needed. You need to know exactly the cathode and anode, so I know which is getting oxidized, which is getting reduced, products over reactants. E naught cell has to be calculated. At equilibrium, when the cell reaches equilibrium, your E cell is zero. The cell is done. E cell is zero. So that tells you at equilibrium, E naught cell equals 0.0591 by N log of Q. Just taking it to the other side. So at equilibrium, if they give you, then you can simplify it. Now that I have set it at equilibrium, I can make this as log of K. This is important because they can ask you questions related to KSP as well. So we'll do a problem based on that as well. So this is what you're going to have. Let's relate what all we have seen so far: thermodynamics, our equilibrium, and electrochemistry. So what all do we know? Yes, we know what delta G, delta G naught, we know our E naught, we know K. So delta G naught and E naught, this is very simple. Delta G naught equals minus NF E naught. We also know this. Delta G naught equals minus RT ln K or minus 2.303 RT log K. Now, I can relate these two right now using these two equations. So, I can say delta G naught equals minus NF E naught, which equals minus RT ln K, or E naught equals RT by NF ln K, or we can simplify this and write it over here. E naught equals 0.0591 by N log of K.
You want to remember this triangle. I usually call this a holy triangle. It relates three different properties. You should be able to do any of them. Now, if you look into it, it's extremely simple. These two will give you this setup. That's one. Second thing, for a spontaneous reaction, E naught is positive. Delta G has to be negative. Hence the thing. Anytime you want a spontaneous reaction, delta G has to be negative. So, going to delta G, I have my negative symbols. Accordingly, you do. For a spontaneous reaction, what all conditions we know right now? Absolutely, we want delta G naught is negative. What about E naught? Positive. What about K value? Now, this is where this is a little tricky. K is always positive. So, K is never going to be negative value. It is between pretty much 0 to infinity. But you don't see those extremes. K value of greater than 1 is spontaneous. K value of less than 1 means E naught is negative and delta G is positive. So, these are the conditions for spontaneity you want to remember. So, remember this. Be able to write them out quickly. You will be able to do problems faster in your exam. Here's a question that has come twice in NEET. Hence, I always say to everybody, solve your previous equations. The same question is repeated here with the same numbers. Imagine how fast you can do this problem if you remember it. Most of the time, the same question is asked or the same pattern is asked. Regardless, it's going to be easier. In the electrochemical cell, the cell has been given. We know a couple of things from before. We have our anode, double bar, cathode. This is going to be oxidation, reduction. This is actually a Daniell cell. Except it is not going to be a standard condition. Standard condition is 1.1 volt. Here they are giving you the conditions. In cell 1, it is 0.01 molar. In cell 2, you're going to change the zinc sulfate to 1 molar. So I'm going to change this to 1 molar in cell 2. I'm going to decrease this into 0.01 molar. So what will happen to the EMF? If you understand electrochemistry very well, you don't have to set up anything. Maybe I'll solve this problem and I'll explain to you how you can do it faster. Here we have our Nernst equation set up for this particular example. E naught cell minus 0.0591 by N. N is actually 2 here, but we are not going to be doing any calculations here. They are not asking you numbers. Log of product over the reactants. Now we have two cells. If you write it separately for the cells, I already have it pre-set up for you guys. You can download this worksheet from the link below. So I have this. Now I'm not going to be solving anything here. We can just look at the numbers and get the answer. They're asking you which is bigger. So in both cases, our E naught cell is the same. So whichever number I'm going to have smaller here, I'm going to be subtracting by a smaller number, meaning the corresponding E will be bigger. So when you see here, this is log of 10 power minus 2. Here, it is going to be log of 10 to the power 2. Obviously, this is going to be a bigger number, right? Because 10 power minus 2 goes to the top, it becomes log of 10 to the power 2. Here, log of 10 to the power minus 2. Log of 10 power minus 2 is minus 2, which comes before the log. Minus times minus is plus. So you're going to add to the E1, whereas here you're going to subtract. So obviously E1 is greater than E2. That's actually a long way of doing. You don't even have to calculate and still it's a long way. The shortest way would be if you just look at your numbers given here, right here. Just identify that this is a product, this is a reactant. This is a product, this is a reactant. So now, I'm increasing my product, I'm decreasing my reactant. Obviously, you increase the product, decrease the reactant means you're going to go towards equilibrium, right? Q value is going to approach K. So, if you were to go and buy a battery in the store, you want a lot of reactants to be there, not products. Hence, my E1 is bigger. So, option is beta. This is a straightforward question. They have again another question that has come two times on NEET. If the E0 cell of the reaction is given, E0 is negative, then what about the delta G and K? We know that E0 has to be positive for a spontaneous reaction. For a spontaneous reaction, delta G has to be negative and K value has to be greater than 1. Here we have E0 is negative, so delta G is positive, K is less than 1. Option is alpha. Don't have to solve anything, just concept based. NEET 2016, this question has come. The pressure of hydrogen required to make the potential of hydrogen electrode zero in a pure water is. So now here you have to be very clear. Hydrogen electrode potential is zero when it is under standard condition. So when you look at your Nernst equation, the E naught cell is zero. They are asking you here, how do you make the E cell zero? So understanding the question. So we pull up our Nernst equation. This is the reaction we have. 2H plus plus 2 electron gives you H2. You can make H plus plus electron gives half H2, that half will take care over here, not an issue. I would use it this way. I don't want to deal with halves. E equals E naught cell minus all this. So they are telling you here, my E cell, I want it to be zero. I know E naught cell is zero. So if E cell has to be zero, then this whole setup has to be zero. When is this whole thing has to be zero? When this is log of one. So this term has to be one, or the pressure of hydrogen equals H plus concentration squared. Now they're telling you pure water. When you go back to your equilibrium, for pure water, we can write Kw equals H plus times OH minus. This is always true. And at 298 Kelvin, I do know my Kw, 10 to the power minus 14. And because it's water, there are as many OH minus as H plus. So I can just do it as X squared or H plus squared, or my H plus equals 10 to the power minus 7. So here pressure of H2 equals 10 to the power minus 7 squared, which is nothing but 10 to the power minus 14. Option is Charlie. Okay, this problem is extremely simple once you set it up. So it's easier if you are able to understand what they are asking you. Hence, electrochemistry is tough when you study, but once you get comfortable, the questions are always two or three steps you can calculate. This particular question was asked in 2013. A button cell was given and they have given you the reactions. You don't have to be comfortable with the reactions. All we know is the box is the target equation. How do I get it from these two equations? One thing we want to know, the target equation has no electrons in it. So it is not a half cell, it's a full cell. I don't have to worry about complications now. So I have these two. How do you set it up? Now when you see here, I have my zinc on the left side, zinc zero. This is on the right side, so I have to flip this equation. And Ag2O on the left side, Ag2O on the left side. It so turns out that you just have to flip this equation, you leave it as it is. And then we do add them, or we can do the other way. So this equation has to be flipped, or we can say that this is not going to get reduced, this is oxidized, meaning it is going to happen at anode. If you flip, this becomes 0.76 positive, but it is the oxidation potential. I have my reaction written as reduction potential. You can flip it and add or leave it as it is. This way, E0 cathode minus E0 anode, we get 1.1 volt. Very similar to our Daniell cell potential. In 2013 has asked this question. A hydrogen gas electrode is made by dipping platinum wire. We have seen this setup in our class lecture. The pH is given as 10. Hydrogen is being passed around at 1 atm. That is extremely useful. The oxidation potential of the electrode would be. Now again, we just solved in a question before for a similar one. Here is the setup of the cell. I have E cell equals E naught cell minus, but E naught is hydrogen electrode zero. So minus 0.0591 by N, pressure of H2 divided by H plus. Here why I have not put a minus sign is, I'm talking about oxidation potential. Hence I flip the equation. Now they're telling you pressure of H2 is 1 atm. Again, you may have set up this equation as oxidation could be H2 gives you 2H plus electrons. You can leave it this way, or you can also have half H2 equals H plus plus electron. Both of them you can use, not a big deal. Here I've used the second one, hence the power 0.5. Now how do they differ if I put a 0.5? Look at the electrons, N equals 1 for this equation. If I use this equation, I would have had pressure of hydrogen to the power 1, but my N would be 2. Isn't it the same? This is 1 by 2. I take it before the log, it will be the same. So it really doesn't matter which you use. If you use this, N equals 2. If you use this, N equals 1. That's all the differences. Automatically, it will take care. Now I have this E cell equals this setup. H plus is, H is 10. H plus is 10 to the power minus 10. You can calculate 0.59 volt. And you want to remember this particular number. It keeps coming over and over again. If you can't remember, it's fine. But if you remember, you will see that it comes so many times on need. This is an interesting problem. The problem looks complicated, but one of the simplest problems that has come in eChem. The Gibbs free energy for the decomposition is given positive 960, and you want to make sure a couple of things. This is kilojoules. The potential difference needed for the electrolytic reduction. So we know that delta G is related to E naught by N value. So all that is complicated in this particular example is calculating the N. There are two ways you can calculate. You can look at the aluminum side, or you can look at the oxygen side. Doesn't really matter, because one is giving electrons, one is taking electrons. So aluminum has gotten reduced, so plus electron. Oxygen was minus 2, has become 0, so minus electrons. Now look at aluminum. Al3 plus has gone to Al0, is 3 electrons. 1 mole Al going to 1 mole Al0 is 3 electrons. What about 2 by 3 Al2 is nothing but, multiply the 2 here, 4 by 3 Al3 plus going to 4 by 3 Al. 1 mole is 3 electrons, 4 by 3 moles is 4 by 3 times 3 equals 4 electrons, and that's your answer, N equals 4. Let's look at the oxygen side. Oxygen goes from minus 2 to 0, 2 electrons. How many oxygens are there? 2 by 3 times 3, that's 2 oxygens. So 2 O2 minus goes to 2 O0, that is 4 electrons, so N equals 4. You can do either way. Once you figure out N equals 4, the question is pretty simple. We have a delta G equals minus NFE. Delta G is given, F you know, which is 96,485, and N is something we just calculated. You see here, I have shown you how to set it up. Now, if you are not good in math, not a big deal. We can still do this. We can approximate. So let's approximate this to 96,000. So that is going to be 100, correct? So that's going to be 10. 10 by 4 is 2.5. Still close enough. We can always approximate. The answers are far away for you. The reduction of silver ions with copper metal, the standard cell potential was found to be. So they're giving you the standard cell potential. So they have done the E0 cathode, E0 anode. They've given you E0 cell. What is the value of Gibbs free energy? Extremely straightforward. First thing we want to do is write down the equation, and right away you can see the balanced equation as 2 electron process. We can do the remaining. N equals 2, F is given to you, E0 is given to you. It's a multiplication, so you don't have to worry. You can, if you want, you can approximate. If you want, you can take it as 1 lakh. 1 lakh times 2 is 2 lakhs. 2 lakhs times 46, about 90. Because I have rounded up, little bit less than 90, which is 89. Very simple. It has come in NEET 2012. The standard free energies of components are given, and they're asking you E0 value. Pretty straightforward. We know that delta G naught equals minus NF E0. Here delta G is going to be calculated from product reactants. We have done this in thermodynamics. The other thing that you have to know is the N value. So here is the reaction I have. We have to calculate the number of electrons. Now it's easier to look at oxygen and figure out number of electrons. So oxygen right here is zero charge. In both cases here, it's minus 2. So oxygen is minus 2. Here it is 0. So each oxygen has gained 2 electrons. How many oxygens are there total? 8 times 2 is 16 oxygens. 2 electrons each, so 32. So N equals 32. Now we have a delta G equals product minus reactants. The balanced equation says 5 times CO2 plus 6 times H2O right here. Minus my pentane. Oxygen is in the standard state by itself. It's a 0. Then when you do the sum, the negative value for delta G, and it's in kilojoules because all these numbers are in kilojoules. Delta G equals minus NFE. We can do here N equals 32.
You don't necessarily need to have different species for the cathode and anode. You can have the exact same species. If you have the exact same species at the exact same concentration, you have reached equilibrium. So your E cell is zero. But what if we have the exact same species at different concentration? For example, we can have two different cells connected through a salt bridge. It's connected to a voltmeter. My electrodes are here. What if this is 0.1 molar copper 2 plus and this is 0.5 molar copper 2 plus, meaning they are different. So a same cell with different concentration is called a concentration cell, as the name explains it. So concentration cell. Concentration cells will have one particular property. If you were to write your Nernst equation, we have E cell equals E naught cell minus 0.0591 by N log of Q. Now for a
Equilibrium, we know that it is K and E cell is 0. For a concentration cell, your E naught cell is 0. Extremely simple. How do you get the E naught cell? E naught cathode minus E naught anode. Since both of them are exactly the same, they'll have the same value. So one and the same, so if you subtract them, you get 0. So for a concentration cell, E cell is minus 0.0591 by N log of Q. This is for a concentration cell. Now you will have your corresponding concentration. So let's say for example, they give you a given cell, copper 0 solid, copper 2 plus, as we take here, 0.1 molar, double bond, copper 2 plus, 0.5 molar, copper 0. Well, this is what we have. So, how do you write the Lenz equation? E cell equals 0.0591 by 2, because this is a 2 electron process. This is my reactant anode, product anode, reactant cathode, product cathode. So, we are going to have log of product over reactants. My product is copper 2 plus. This is solid, activity is 1, so we don't take it, divided by copper 2 plus in my product and reactant. So, in our case, it is going to be minus 0.0591 by 2 log of. So, now I will have my products on the top, so which is going to be 0.1 divided by 0.5.
Now, what we have here is 0.1 divided by 0.5, you can approximate it as 1 divided by 5. Log of 1 divided by 5 can be written as minus log 5, minus into minus is plus. So, this cell is going to be spontaneous. If the concentrations are given differently, this is here, this here, it doesn't really matter, but this is where it matters. What if I give you 0.5 here and 0.1 here? How do you know, just looking at it, you don't have to do all this, just looking at it, how do you know whether the cell is going to be spontaneous? Look at this, for example, what happens, this is your product concentration, this is your reactant concentration. So, if the cell goes as it is, if it is spontaneous, what happens to reactant goes down, what happens to product goes up. Makes sense, this is higher in number, so it has to go down, this is lower in number, it has to go up until they meet. So, easier, if I give you 0.5 here and 0.1 here, meaning you are forming something that is more stronger, that is not going to be there. This level of understanding, maybe if you do an example, you will be able to do.
Now that we have seen Nernst equation and also concentration cells, let's practice few more problems. Here I have given you zinc 2 plus giving you zinc, and what happens when I dilute the zinc 2 plus concentration 100 times. So the basic equation is going to be zinc 2 plus getting reduced to give you the corresponding zinc 0 solid. So the concentration of this used to be X, now it has become X by 100. So what has happened to E cell? If you notice here, they don't give you E naught cell because E naught cell does not depend on concentration, only E cell does. Now what has happened to E cell? We don't need to know the E naught values, we are going to see the calculation right now. Now if you set up an Ernst equation for this setup, I have E cell equals E naught cell minus 0.0591 by 2 because 2 electron process, log of concentration of zinc solid divided by zinc 2 plus, zinc solid being unity, so 1 by zinc 2 plus. Now what I have to do is just basically make this divided by 100, diluted by 100 times. Diluted by 100 times meaning divided by 100, so I have denominator going to the numerator. So this has gone to the numerator, 100 by this. So this is nothing but 100 times 1 by zinc 2 plus, which is A times B. Log of A times B is log A plus log B. So this is a common factor, so I have it in both cases, log of A plus log of B, this minus is carried over from here. This is nothing but what used to be E1 cell, what we had before, we can call it E1, minus 0.0591 by 2 log of 100. This minus sign is going to prevail. If it prevails, log of 100 is 2, 2 and 2 cancels out, so it is positive 0.059 volts or 59 millivolts. This minus sign is going to be there, meaning compared to my E1, my E2 is going to be subtracted by this much value, so it decreases by 59 millivolts. It's a pretty good problem, and this pattern has come a couple of times in JEE, used to be called AAEE, and also your NEET exam. The next one is a straightforward question. It's an AAEE question. Now it is called IIT JEE Mains, or specifically JEE Mains. What will be the EMOF of the given cell? Now we can see that it's the same cell on both sides, meaning your E naught is zero. It's a hydrogen cell, just a concentration cell. Now if you see, these two concentrations are same, but still the pressures of hydrogens are different. So accordingly, it is going to change. Now if I were to set it up, my anodic reaction and cathodic reaction are same, but opposite in directions, and the concentrations or the pressures of hydrogens are different. If you write Nernst equation for it, E cell equals E naught, which is 0, minus RT by 2F, ln of H plus squared. Here if you see, this is my product. So this is my product, H plus squared divided by reactant H plus squared. Even if you make a mistake, they will cancel out, luckily, but let's not do it. And this is my reactant, hydrogen gas, P1. So that goes to the bottom, P1, P2 goes to the top. Now what has happened is, if you simplify this, you can see that it is going to be minus. If you take it inside, it will become RT by 2F ln of P1 by P2. They are missing a factor here, LOG. So if you had done none of these, that is also a correct option. But if assuming that it is given as LOG, then it would be minus goes inside P1 by P2. So it will be beta. This is a very good question into CBSE PMT, means CBSE pre-medical test, which you have changed into AIPMT, and now the new name is NEET. An electrochemical series is set up. If you look at it, it seems like two different cells, but it's actually a concentration cell in certain way. H plus concentration is different. Even though concentration looks 0.1 and 0.1, you don't have the same H plus concentration, because equilibrium tells this is a strong electrolyte. Concentration of H plus is 0.1. Concentration of H plus here is less than 0.1, because degree of dissociation is not 1. It's less than 1 or less than 100%. So hence the EMF of the cell is not zero. These two are not going to have the same EMF, because the two acids are different, doesn't matter. The molarities are same, doesn't matter. It's concentration cell, not really, but it's the pH values are different from the for the two acids. See, the acids are different, but that is not the reason. Molarities are same. If molarities are same, then EMF has to be zero. It's a concentration cell in a way, but it doesn't explain it. But the pH values are different, hence your EMF is not going to be zero. Calculate the cell potential for the concentration cell with two silver electrodes with concentration 0.2 and 3. They don't tell you what is the E naught of silver electrode, because it is going to get cancelled out. We can write the basic reaction, which is going to be the same for both, except this is a reduction reaction. It's a cathode. Anode is going to be Ag, giving you Ag2 plus plus 2 electrons. The cell notation is pretty straightforward. Same cell on both sides, concentrations are different. If you were to write Nernst equation, this is what you're going to get. Now this, I have shown you guys how to do log. We can do it as 2 times 10 to the power minus 2. Log 2 is 0.3 and log 3 also is 0.5. I've taught you this. If you are able to do this, then you can calculate your E value. Here in the particular problem, the minus sign was missing. Otherwise, Charlie and Delta are the same option. It does happen in NEET. If the minus sign was missing, that is not the correct option. This would be the correct option. Option would be Delta. At this point, because Charlie and Delta are same, you can say either of them. Again, I'm leaving you this part. If you do not know how to condense this math, look at the equilibrium lecture. I've taught you that. Calculate the concentration of the unknown. Like this concentration, it's a concentration cell, except this time they give you the E cell, they ask you concentration. It's straightforward. Now if you see, E cell equals E naught minus what we have, N is 1 because it's silver, log of product anode divided by reactant cathode, everything else is being unity, so X by 1. Now you can calculate X. Now E naught is going to be 0, so you can take the negative to the other side and divide by 0.05. 0.26 and 0.05, you can actually calculate it easily. You can calculate X value. Now I have shown you the calculation here, how to do it. I would advise you guys to do it yourself and look at the calculations. And here is a final question that I would like you guys to try it yourself. Hydrogen electrode dipped in solution, two different solutions, pH is 3 and 5, meaning H plus is 10 power minus 3 and 10 power minus 6. Write down the cell equation, know your reactants properly, products properly, set up the Nernst equation, you will get the answer easily. 10 power minus 3 and 10 power minus 6 are much easier to do log.